Okay, welcome. I suggest that we start this meeting. It's almost like a regular classroom. good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. A warm welcome to all of you in this special room that we have. It's called the Senaatzaal. A special welcome also to Marina van Damme. I'm really glad that you're able to come to this meeting today. But also a special welcome to the members of the jury, the supervisors of the nominees, and clearly also friends and family, but foremost of all, to the nominees and winners of today. So you'll see who is the winner. Last year was full with all sorts of academic achievements, many research grants, high quality research with significant scientific and social impact, world championships of our student teams, and a lot more. We take, as a university, much pride in these achievements. We are very attentive in fostering an environment in which all of our students and staff are able to prosper and grow. Both in our own specialized domains, as well as in a fruitful collaboration with each other and the outside world. There's a lot of collaboration among university, and in particular this university has a very rich tradition to collaborate with Brainport Eindhoven and all the companies that are involved in it. Because it's the combination of these skills where true excellence lies. And one of our main priorities, as we highlighted recently in the Strategy 2030, is to value excellence and to give proper reward and recognition when rightly earned. And I think you are beautiful examples thereof. We therefore highly appreciate the annual academic awards, our moment where true excellence is being celebrated. With special respect to the four winners of this year's academic awards, we would like to present to you all the nominees that we have for the Bachelor of Science, the Master of Science, Professional Doctorate in Engineering, and the PhD contenders of the 2019 Academic Awards. All nominees were chosen within their own departments or bachelor or graduate program from a large pool, I would say, of outstanding candidates. And these candidates and contenders all showcase the wonderful achievements that can be achieved when you really commit to what you're doing. All these results of our students and young researchers are, in our view, outstanding in their scientific approach and contribution, in their innovative potential, and their potential future impact on society. With their work, these contenders truly serve as an example to their colleagues and their peers. Now, I would like to compliment and congratulate all the nominees and staff on the magnificent job that they have delivered, and hope that you will take pleasure in familiarizing yourself with their research. Now, I will start with the Bachelor of Science Award. And it's actually the first time that we have this award. In their meeting, the jury members thoroughly compared and discussed the individual scores and general impressions of the paper, and this resulted in a unanimous choice for the winner. Johan Kom. Ik ga even. Ik moet even niet de prijs geven. It makes sense to have an award, right? Congratulations, sir. Cool. Yeah, maak even een foto van jou. Okay. So we take pleasure in listening to you. A short pitch of what your thesis was all about. Yep. Als je deze vast, heb ik al een paar minuten.
Hi everyone, welcome. As you already know, I'm Johan, and today I'll be telling you about my bachelor research very shortly. I did my bachelor research.
Can you understand him in the back?
No.
No, I thought so. Yep.
No? Yes?
No? No? Technische Universiteit Eindhoven.
Ja. kunnen niks.
Test.
Yeah.
Always nice to be at the Technical University. So, let's start over. I'm Johan, welcome. I'll be telling you shortly about my research. I did my research with Tech United, which is a multidisciplinary team playing soccer with robots. We participate in the RoboCup Middle-Sized League, which is a league characterized by the fact that all the sensors have to be on board of the robot, so there's no external help. Additionally, the environment is highly dynamic due to large accelerations and velocities combined with frequent collisions. This makes playing soccer difficult. So in order to play soccer, you need to know where you are, first and foremost. The environment poses a challenge as the aggressive nature highlights the drawbacks of each sensor. So in order to overcome this, I've designed a framework in which I combine multiple sensors with a model in order to accurately and robustly know where the robot is at all times. This allowed the robot to know where it is, and thus we are able to play soccer very well, which allowed us to win the World Championship in Sydney for the fifth time this year. Thank you.
Thank you. Thanks.
Winning once already is a major achievement, or doing it five times in a row, I think, is a big achievement of this team. We now move to the Master of Science Thesis Award. And I invite all nominees for the Master of Science to come forward, and I will name you one by one. And then you'll come forward and you get a certificate for me. Every year, each of the master programs nominates the best thesis for the Master Thesis Award. I'm going to give you each of you a certificate in recognition of the achievement of being the best of your specific graduate program. And that, ladies and gentlemen, by itself, I think is already an outstanding achievement. Concerning the procedure, I will present the certificates at each nominee in alphabetical order, so you now know a little bit in what sequence you will be called. First, Alan Cardinals from Industrial and Applied Mathematics. David Duqueux, I hope I pronounced it correctly, Sustainable Energy Technology. I'll take this with me. Juliana Frans, Life Sciences and Engineering. Daan de Geus, Automotive Technology. Maaike Kompier. Innovation Sciences. Hidden yourself. Proficiat. Robin Mennens, Computer Science. Felix Ros, Industrial Design. Matthijs Schoenmakers. Badia Sharif, Electrical Engineering. Jeroen Sol, Chemical Engineering and Chemistry. There's someone that couldn't make it today because he had to take a course from his current employer. Niels van Stijn, so it's unfortunate that he couldn't make it. And Tijmen Vermeij, Mechanical Engineering. You are here. Oh. Yeah. alsjeblieft. Okay. So it's quite a talent. If you're an employer, I would have a good look at these candidates. Really outstanding candidates. Congratulations to all of you for outstanding achievement. And I now have to announce the winner.
Just a moment. The supervisor of Niels & Stein is here. Okay.
Bob Walraven. Good. Yeah. Bob, yeah. Sorry. Okay. Bob? Sorry. That's good. That's good. So I have the pleasure to announce the winner. Tijmen van Meij. Jesus Award.
Je krijgt
een groot. You get a big one. Come, see if I give this back. Congratulations. Okay, good. Now I think you can be seated again, because we're going to listen to the winner. Yep, it's yours.
Test. Thank you. So I'm Tijmen, and I did my master thesis on materials. So I think everyone knows that materials are really important in today's world. For example, your cars is made of different kinds of metals. Your phones, your tablets, your computers, they have chips with certain properties without which they cannot function. So at the left here, you see the scale of a human hair. You see different colors which determine the properties of the material at a very small scale, so the width of a hair. And one of these diffraction patterns on the right, they give some more information on each point in the material. And if you go to the next slide. And in my project, we try to get some more idea of a better idea of the 3D stress state of the material. So we want to understand how the material behaves in 3D. So on the left, I did some experimental work, and you see an ion beam hitting a sample, and then we want to remove material and make a 3D image by taking different scans. And on the right, you see one of these diffraction patterns, and we did advanced image correlation on it to extract the stress state in one certain point in the material. And if we can combine that, we can really get new insights in the materials. But this wasn't only possible by myself. This guy is my supervisor, Johan, and besides drinking beer, as he likes very much, as you see, and the same for all my other colleagues in the multiscale lab, he has been instrumental in my research, and he has advised me very well, and still doing the same in my PhD project. And I want to thank him, and also my other colleagues, Mark van Maris, and friends in the multiscale lab, and my family as well. Thanks.
Thank you. Yeah. Thank you, Tijmen. So the next award that we have is for the Professional Doctorate in Engineering program that we have. And I will invite the nominees to come forward as well. The university goes to the best project for one of the technological PEDENG programs of the Stan Akkermans Institute. As is the case of the master program, they will line up here and get a certificate from me individually. So let me read the names. Thijs van Bruksvoort, Clinical Informatics. Okay. Ah. Thijs couldn't make it because of family circumstances. Koen van Kempen, Process and Product Design. Dimitro Kondrashov, Software Technology. Nikita Kruis, Qualified Medical Engineer. Fernando Nunez from Design of Electrical Engineering Systems, He also couldn't make it today, unfortunately, because his employer needs him. David Ocello from Automator Systems Design. Joanne Stipp, Industrial Engineering. En Jelle van der Velde, User System Interaction. So who would be the winner? Who would you select? Now, then we clearly had a jury that looked at all the theses individually with a lot of care. Dimitro, you won it. So, the big award is yours. Yeah? Okay, give it to me. I will exchange it for the microphone, and thank you, and congratulations.
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Dmytro. It's a big honor to stand here today and receive the PDENG Award for the Intelligent Microscope Project. And I think the most interesting question to address within the short time that I have what Intelligent Microscope is. So the main intention of the project was to create a software prototype of the system that can show capabilities of currently available AI methods integrated into microscope software. So how interaction with electron microscopes can look in the future. Within 10 months dedicated for the project, I addressed this question by creating a software prototype that can understand predefined user voice commands. It can control electron microscope. It can detect objects on microscope images and highlight specific objects requested by the user. So on the next slide, you see the example of a microscope image with highlighted big mitochondria in red shape in relation to cell sizes in blue shape. I would like to show my gratitude and say thank you to my supervisors, Remco Schoonmakers and Mikola Paciniski, to PDENG Software Technology Generation 2016, and our project program director, Janja Desuren, my family and friends. I will take all the knowledge gained during my PDENG studies and take it with me to my future career adventures. Thank you all.
Thank you very much. So the one but last award that we're going to hand out is the PhD Thesis Award. For the best PhD thesis of last year. I would like to again invite the nominees for this award to come forward, and we'll name you one by one. Bram Kappers, from the Mathematics and Computer Science Department. Bas van Genebeek, Chemical Engineering and Chemistry. Bart Klarenaar, Applied Physics. D.D. Kommers, Industrial Design. Ruud van Sloan, Electrical Engineering. Maar die is Talmar, Industrial Engineering and Innovation Sciences. Yassine Toparlar, Belt Assignment. Jurgen van Zundert is on vacation in South Africa. But his father is here to receive the award. So, that's a nice picture to share. So I now would like to announce the winner. Stressful moment, right? Even more stressful than the defense that you had last year. But the winner is Yassine. Maybe you can be seated, and Yassine will present his results. It's not the first time that you win an award with your thesis, right? No. He's had several awards already, and perhaps an important thing, I think, that doesn't happen all that often, we have a sort of a world list of highly cited papers, and he's on that list for quite a while. So that's a major achievement, I would say. The floor is yours.
Well, thank you. Thank you for the award. It's a pleasure to be here. I think we can have the first slide, if it's possible. No? Ah, there are no slides. Okay. No problem. Okay. Well, basically, I had some slides, but I cannot show it, apparently. Basically, my research was about cities, and specifically about cities that are really different from each other, with their looks, with their buildings, with their people, in fact, as well. And they are so different, in fact, they have their own microclimates. And as the cities become more urbanized and larger, they tend to become warmer. Well, since we all live in the Netherlands, having a warmer city might be a good thing, but it's not a nice thing in all the circumstances, because we expect that the building energy consumption will increase quite significantly in the 21st century due to climate change and urbanization. And in our research, what we did was, instead of designing the buildings only for higher energy efficiency and human thermal comfort, we've decided to basically design the urban microclimate itself. And we've come up with a methodology where you can actually test, simulate different options in the cities. You could simulate the urban microclimate and assess its effect on the buildings and on the humans as well. Well, as it's already mentioned, the thesis has received national and international awards. And it has received tremendous support from my supervisors, Bert Blocken, Hetjan van Eist, and Bino Maiho from Vito, along with my family and my friends, especially my friends from TU Eindhoven for that. I'm extremely grateful to them. Thank you very much.
So that we now have come to the end of the bachelor and graduate programs that we have. But I would like to say that each of you can be extremely proud of what you have achieved today. It's really amazing that if you're being selected as the best of your year in a particular program, and it's always an almost impossible task for a jury to pick out the best of the best, if you like. So I really hope that you feel very proud of what you have achieved today. We now go to a special part of the program, and that is the Marina van Damme grant applications. And I would like to give the floor to Elfie Nederson. I have these names.
Okay, thank you. Well, I think it's the 10th time that I'm standing here. Is that correct? Yeah, it's true. Eh? It's the 10th time. So, well, good afternoon again. My name is Elfie Nederson, like Frank already said, and I'm a full professor as chair of building sustainability at the Department of the Built Environment. And I was chair of the jury that appoints the winner of the Marina van Damme Grant. And I'm very pleased to see that Marina van Damme made the effort to be present at an age at, am I allowed to say that? Yeah, she's 90 years old, which is, well. And the same goes for Lisanne van Oppen, representative of the Marina van Damme Network that exists out of the winners out from the Marina van Damme grants. And she won the grant in 2016. Also warm welcome, of course, to the representative of the Eindhoven University Fund member and also member of the jury, Jan van Oosterveld. Jan Oosterveld, zonder de van. Sorry. Eindhoven University of Technology is keen to give a career boost to its female engineering graduates of our PhDs. The Marina van Damme grant is a nudge in the right direction for them. The grant is worth €9,000 and is intended to deepen or extend knowledge to provide international orientation in the shape of a study, a traineeship or a project. Thanks to Marina van Damme, the grant can be awarded each year by the University Fund Eindhoven. She also donates a runners-up award of €2,500 for the runner-up. And I think for that, and she has done that for many years, and she will do that for many years to come, I think we ought her an applause again. So. And every year, the jury evaluates application for the Marina van Damme grant, taking into account the personal significance for the respective candidates, the link with business and industry, other societal relevance of the topics, originality and practicability. Sorry, yeah, that's a difficult word for me. Well, these are the four things that we look at, and I really must say that we had tremendous, good, very high-ranked candidates. We really had a difficult job, hey, Jan and Yvonne. You know that we had to discuss a lot because we didn't agree at all. There were many years that we agreed on who would be the winner quite easily, but we had so many reasons why she should be win, and then the other said, well, she should also win, and we couldn't grant all of them, so we had a difficult job, but nevertheless, Fernanda Neira D'Angelo and Eline Siebesma were the two applicants that were the best, we thought. And I'm very pleased because one of them is the runner-up, one is the winner, and I'm very pleased to announce that the jury has decided that the winner of the Marina van Damme Grant 2019 is Fernanda Neira D'Angelo. You have to wait a little bit, but stand right here, because first of all, we would like to show the runner-up, and that's, of course, Eline Siebesma. She's the runner-up of the Marina van Damme Grant. She's not able to be present today, unfortunately, but she was able to send us a small film. Oh, yeah, okay, start it.
Hi, my name is Eline Siebesma, and I work on small molecular glues for protein complexes to finding new medicine. Unfortunately, I cannot be here in the award ceremony today, but I hope to tell you a little bit about my work in this small video pitch. Over the last 4 years during my PhD research, I've worked on the estrogen receptor protein, which is a major driver in the majority of breast cancer cases. By gluing this protein together to an adapter protein, we can maybe find an alternative way for the treatment of resistant breast cancer. I've pioneered, together with the University of California in San Francisco, several approaches to finding these small molecules that are acting as small molecule glues for proteins. Currently, we are investigating if we can further develop these molecules towards the clinic, And also if we can apply these approaches to other disease proteins for difficult to treat diseases. We would like to do this in a biotechnology startup, and the Marina van Damme grant would allow me to take part in this startup from an early stage and develop myself further as a researcher and entrepreneur. I would like to thank Marina van Damme for the availability for this grant, many years already. I would like to thank the jury and all of you for your attention. Thank you.
Well, that was Eline Siebesma. She's, you can imagine that if she's the runner-up, we have a big expectations from you because you are the winner and you can present your work in 10 minutes as well.
Thank you very much. Well, no pressure about the expectations. Well, I'm very excited to be here today and be able to tell you a little bit about myself, my ambitions and how I'm planning to achieve them. Yeah, you can move on. This was my first slide. So I was born and raised in the 80s, as you can see from my hair. And I was raised under the principle that combining, a family and a professional ambition was not a contradiction, that they would rather be able to sustain themselves and to propel each other through care, support, and sense of achievement. So with this... these values, I found my place in the Netherlands, where I became a doctor in chemical reactor engineering and now an assistant professor in the same field. And I also started my own family together with my husband, who is also an assistant professor, and our daughter, who was born with a very severe handicap, sadly, but teaches us every day a very good lesson about resilience. So, as a chemical engineer, I'm deeply concerned about the environment and about the sustainability of our environment. And for that reason, I dedicate my research to develop novel technologies that are that will be able to create what I will call here the future biorefinery, which is nothing else but the future chemical industry that will be able to convert waste materials or renewable resources into valuable materials. So, for example, maybe you can go to the next slide. In my PhD project, I developed a microreactor system to produce valuable hydrogen from something that we could consider as a waste. And in my current position, I continue to develop novel concepts like this one. However, in order to create a real impact on the future biorefinery, I consider that it is important, it is actually crucial to bridge the gap between my academic innovations and what industry really needs. And for that purpose, I proposed for this grant to support me in my plan to become a guest researcher at a company called KT in Rome, which is a company which is very strongly committed towards sustainability and very interested in technologies like, for example, hydrogen for hydrogen production. And in this case, I could increase the impact of my research and eventually propel my career, contribute to really make a contribution to sustainable development, and at the same time, take care of my family life and continue to enjoy it. So with that, I want to thank, well, first of all, Marina van Damme for the grant, the jury, and of course, my family and you for your attention.
And now, our Rector Magnificent will give you hand over the award.
The big award. Here we go. Congratulations.
Thank you very much. Frank laten doen.
And there's also a statue. Can you?
Yeah. Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
Congratulations.
Yeah. Okay. Now it's to you.
To me again. Yeah, thank you. Thank you so much. We are at the end of this meeting. I hope you enjoyed the meeting. In particular, I hope you enjoyed to listen to these exceptionally talented individuals. Whenever you're negative about perhaps the future of the world, look at these young people and have big confidence in them. Yeah, I do. I'm always amazed and impressed by the creativity and ingenuity that you have and the ambitions that you have. It's really wonderful to see. For now, this is the where we want to be. There will be drinks for celebration next to this floor. The winners of this afternoon, you still have an obligation, and that is to be at Momentum that will start at 4 o'clock. So you will be sort of full display, if you like, this afternoon. Unfortunately, for some of you, Momentum has been sold out. We have a fully packed afternoon, about 1,200 graduates that get their award this afternoon. We celebrate that, which means that the Markthal, as you know it, is fully packed with 3,500 people. But you can live stream, so the whole event will be live streamed, and you can follow it either here or at some other location. I have to run now to get myself prepared for the big event at 4 o'clock and hope to see at least 4 of you there this afternoon. Yeah? Thank you very much.